Check test. Test, test, test. Lead me lest I stray, lest I stray. Gently down the stream of time, stream of time. Lead me, Savior, all the way, all the way. Savior, check test, 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 test.
Like I said, we'll do three verses of the concluding of the communion song, or of invitation song. There we are. Good morning, Church Online. Are you there? We'll be right back in a little bit. Kind of zoomed in. Thank you. Good, good, good. Good. Here, and we'll get the sound down. Good morning, Church Online. Welcome. Welcome. All right, good morning, everyone. Welcome. Okay, so I need to do one more thing. Dan, in that power box right there, could you turn the power on or tell Bobby? Could you? There you go, Bobby. Okay, there. Oops, I'm back. Hi, I'm back. We had to take care of some minor difficulties there. There, we're on. Yeah, okay. Sorry for banging in that. Okay, good morning. Wow, it's good to see everyone. What a great week of snow and ice and everything, and appreciate that we have good, clear walks, and appreciate all that, and we can come together this way. Hey, today, as we look through our study about spiritual disciplines and spiritual formation, growth, really, right, spiritual growth, we're going to look at a growing and learning and living in God's Word. So we're going to look back at Scripture. And this little song, you might recognize it from a Psalm. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet. Would you sing it with me as we get started this morning? Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid, I think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. Nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. We'll stop there, and I'm going to skip through the second verse there. As we look today about, our study will be about life in God's Word. But right now, as we, our traditional start is to have announcements, and we have those standing ready. Ready, set, go.
Welcome to those here and those there, and we are glad to be together. Just before Greg started, I heard a familiar sound that we have not heard a lot lately, and over the past year anyway, was the buzzing of conversation in the audience here and in the assembly, and that's so good to hear. It was always the way we would begin. Greg would come up here, and there would be a lot of people talking and visiting, and he'd have to kind of quiet them down. So we'll hope to get more noise as the as this year goes on, where we get recovery from what we've been in. Okay, get a bulletin. I'm actually just going to kind of read it to you or hit some of the highlights, and if I miss your highlight, I'm sorry. The mention the Secret Sisters. Read that on page 2 and get a hold of Sherry. Usually they're gathering this time of year for a luncheon, but won't happen under the current conditions. In our sick that we've been praying for, Alan Crawford did not get news that they'd hoped for. He has some serious issues that he's going to be dealing with, and we want to pray for Alan and his family. This is of great concern to them, and so let's be with them in our prayers and let them know by card or call or text or whatever that we are on his team. Jerry's dad is struggling and having tests, and so we'll be praying for them. See, Bill is having some issues in his hands, and I'm going to pray for Bill Walker. We haven't seen Bill for a year now. Doug and Cindy have the COVID. Eddie, as we announced last week, broke his arm on the ice, and so we're praying for them. Beth had successful surgery, and she's anticipating feeling better than she has for a long, long time. So let's be giving thanks for that one. Barb is going to have surgery on her foot, so be praying for Barb. And others that have been on our list, we want to continue to pray that Anthony gets a job in the schools. He would like that. So Richard Danielson finished his monitor, sent it in, and now he gets to wait 3 weeks for him to tell him what it said. So sometimes things don't move like we'd like them to. And the last note there that you have in your prayer list is those who are in homes and have been sequestered and lonely, you know, that's something really to think about and be with in our prayers. If we can send them cards or any kind of indication that they aren't alone, that would really be wonderful. So, all right, Ken's going to lead our singing again today. Look forward to praising God in song. And as we begin, we will do so in prayer, of course. Wes is going to lead us in a prayer.
Can you pray with me, please? Father in heaven, as we come in prayer, we give you all honor and glory. Father, we thank you for this morning as we, as your children, can come together in spirit to learn and to worship you, Father. And I ask that you bless each and every one that's taking the time to focus on you, to focus on the love that you've given to us through your Son, through the written word that you've given to us, and ultimately the salvation that we have in heaven. And Father, I ask at this time you be with the many that we've mentioned that need your help. Please be with Alan and their family as they deal with the physical issues that he has. Again, Father, be with Barb as she has her upcoming surgery. Be with Eddie as he heals from his broken arm. Again, be with Bill and Beth and all those that we've mentioned. They're dealing with physical issues, dealing with the virus. Again, Father, be with those that have dealt with isolation from this. We ask that you be with them and help them and comfort them and help them overcome those issues. Father, again, put us in a position where we can help to show the love, to be able to be supportive. Again, Father, I appreciate this time as a family that we get to spend with you to show our love, to show our obedience, and to show our faith. I ask that you be with Ken as he leads us in singing this morning, and I ask that you be with Greg as he presents your word. We are so grateful for your word. We're grateful for the Gospel of John, to understand more about you and to mostly understand about our Savior, about Jesus and what he's done for us. Again, Father, we love you so much. We thank you for everything. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Give me the Bible, star of gladness gleaming, to cheer the wanderer, lone and tempest-tossed. No storm can hide that radiance peaceful beaming, since Jesus came to seek and save the lost. Give me the Bible, holy message shining, thy light shall guide me in the narrow way. Precept and promise, law and love combining, till night shall vanish in eternal day. Give me the Bible when my heart is broken, when sin and grief have filled my soul with fear. Give me the precious words by Jesus spoken. Hold up his lamp to show my Savior near. Give me the Bible, holy message shining. Thy light shall guide me in the narrow way. Precept and promise, law and love combining, till night shall vanish in eternal day. Give me the Bible, all my steps enlighten, teach me the danger of the realms below. That lamp of safety o'er the gloom shall brighten, that light alone the path of peace can show. Give me the Bible, holy message shining. Thy light shall guide me in the narrow way. Precept and promise, law and love combining, till night shall vanish in eternal day. Give me the Bible, lamp of life immortal, hold up that splendor by the open grave. Show me the light from heaven's shining portal. Show me the glory gilding Jordan's wave. Give me the Bible, holy message shining. Thy light shall guide me in the narrow way. Precept and promise, law and love combining, till night shall vanish in eternal day. After this song, David Hogan's will direct us in prayer. Sweetly, Lord, have we heard thee calling, come, follow me. And we see where thy footprints falling lead us to thee. Footprints of Jesus that make the pathway glow. We will follow the steps of Jesus where'er they go. Though they lead o'er the cold, dark mountains, seeking his sheep, or along by the Siloam's fountain, helping the weak. Footprints of Jesus that make the pathway glow. We will follow the steps of Jesus where'er they go. If they lead through the whole, no holy preaching the word, or in homes of the poor and lowly serving the Lord. Footprints of Jesus that make the pathway glow. We will follow the steps of Jesus where'er they go. By and by through the shining portal, mortals turning our feet. We shall walk with the glad immortals have golden street. Footprints of Jesus that make the pathway glow. We will follow the steps of Jesus where'er they go.
Let's pray together. Dear God, we thank you so much for letting us live another week to come together and to worship you. We pray for all those that are gathered today in your name that we can worship you in a way that makes you happy and that helps us to become more like you want us to be. Dear God, we thank you so much for the young people, the children that we have in this congregation and the joyful noise that they make. We just pray that we can all be good examples and help these young folks to truly love you the way you want them to. Dear God, we pray for all those that we've mentioned earlier that need your help, especially with physical needs. Even though we may not feel their pain in our own bodies, we feel their pain in our hearts because they are part of our family. Dear God, we just pray for your comfort, to give them strength, to know that you are in control. Even though we suffer in this life sometimes, as a song that we sing, this is not our home. We're just passing through. We so look forward to being with you in paradise forever. Dear God, we thank you for all the leaders that we have. We thank you for our elders, our preacher, our teachers. We just pray that they will look to you for guidance, strength, and courage. We pray especially for this country, that we can be a normal country again and be a Christian country. Dear God, we just thank you so much for everything that you do for us. Each and every day, you bless us in so many ways, especially we that live in this great country. We pray that we can maybe take the time to truly count our blessings, know how lucky we are to have loving people around us, most of all to have you, to have the Holy Spirit that dwells within us, to have the angels that watch over us, and to have Jesus as a friend who's always there. Dear God, we pray these things in his holy name. Amen.
At the conclusion of the song, Gary is going to lead us in partaking of the Lord's Supper. Would you live for Jesus and be always pure and good? Would you walk with him within the narrow road? Would you have him bear your burden, carry all your load? Let him have his way with thee. His power can make you what you ought to be. His blood can cleanse your heart and make you free. His love can fill your soul and you will see 'twas best for him to have his way with thee. Would you have him make you free and follow at his call? Would you know the peace that comes by giving all? Would you have him save you so that you'd never fall? Let him have his way with thee. His power can make you what you ought to be. His blood can cleanse your heart and make you free. His love can fill your soul and you will see 'twas best for him to have his way with thee. Would you in his kingdom find a place of constant rest? Would you prove him true each providential test? Would you in his service labor always at your best? Let him have his way with thee. His power can make you what you ought to be. His blood can cleanse your heart and make you free. His love can fill your soul and you will see 'twas best for him to have his way with thee.
Thank you, Ken. His power, his blood, and his love. That's good. We're just going to set our minds toward the Lord's Supper. In the back, there's bread and wine on the table. If somebody didn't get it, just raise your hand up. There'll be somebody in the back to help you. Church family's getting bigger each week. I can see it, Greg. They're all coming back. So, as we start our life, our family, as a Christian family, we have the love from our father and mother, and they watch over us. As we are a married couple, we have love for one another, and the little babies that are born have the love of God in us. As you grow and you become a little toddler, people watch out to keep you safe. God's always with us in that matter. We go off to school and off to college, and we try to make good decisions, and we have prayers toward God to make sure make the right decisions. We always want to make sure that we're thinking of Christ all during our work week and during our life. If you'll turn with me to Psalm 19, verse 7. It says a little bit about what Ken's song was about, the power of the Lord, the love, and a little bit about the blood in the psalm that I'm going to read it last here. The law of the Lord is perfect, restoring the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple. The precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The commandment of the Lord is pure, enlightening the eyes. The fear of the Lord is clean, enduring forever. The judgments of the Lord are true. They are righteous together, altogether. They are more desirable than gold, yes, than much fine gold. Sweeter also than honey and the drippings of honeycomb. Moreover, by them thy servant is warned. In keeping them there is great reward. Who can discern his errors? Acquit me of hidden faults. Also keep back thy servant from presumptuous sins. Let them not rule over me. Then I shall be blameless, and I shall be acquitted of great transgression. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my rock, my redeemer. And turn to Psalm 75:1. And on verse 8, it'll talk about the cup of the hand of the Lord. But we'll start with 1. We give thanks to thee, O God. We give thanks, for thy name is near. Men declare the wondrous works. When I select an appointment in time, it is I who judge with equity. The earth and all who dwell in it melt. It is I who have firmly set its pillars. I said to the boastful, do not boast, and to the wicked, do not lift up the horn. Do not lift up your horn on high. Do not speak with isolent pride.
For not from the east nor from the west nor from the desert come exaltation, but God is the judge. He puts down one and exalts the other. For a cup is in the hand of the Lord, and the wine foams. It is well mixed, and he pours out of this. Surely all the wicked of the earth must strain and drink down its dregs. Take the cup. I'll say a prayer for the cup first, or for the bread first. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day in time that you provided Jesus, your son, to live on this earth and to teach and to make people aware of what's right and what's wrong, to do what is good for the earth. As the time passed, Christ gave up his life, his body, which hung on the cross for our sins. And we do remember his body through this bread. And it's in his name we pray. Amen. Father, we continue our prayer to you, and how tragic that Jesus gave his life on the cross and the blood that was shed. It would have been a time that lots of tears were passed, lots of sorrow. And as Christ hung on the cross and the blood was shed, people were in awe of what was happening. Later in time that we can enjoy the risen Christ. But right now we partake of the fruit of the vine, remembering his blood shed on the cross is for our sins to be given, forgiven. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Continue our prayer for offering. As we go through the times of the COVID that we're in, we want to remember the church and the needs of the church and all our mission work. We pray that as people can, they contribute to the needs of the church. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. If you have a contribution, there's a basket in the back as we leave.
Sweet are the promises, kind is the word. Dear far than any message man ever heard. Pure was the mind of pride, sinless I see. He the great example is and pattern for me. Where he leads I follow, follow all the way. Follow Jesus every day. Sweet is the tender love Jesus has shown, sweeter far than any love that mortals have known. Kind to the erring one, faithful is he. He's a great example is in pattern for me. Where he leads I follow, follow all the way. Where he leads I follow, follow Jesus every to his loving words, come unto me. Weary, heavy laden, there is sweet rest for thee. Trust in his promises, faithful and sure. Lean upon the Savior and the soul is secure. Where he leads I follow, follow all the way. Where he leads I follow, follow Jesus. Sing them over again to me, wonderful words of life. Let me more of their beauty see, wonderful words of life. Words of life and beauty, teach me faith and duty. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Christ the Blessed One gives to all wonderful words of life. Sinner, list to the loving call, wonderful words of life. All so freely given, wooing us to heaven. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Sweetly echo the gospel call, wonderful words of life. Offer pardon and peace to all, wonderful words of life. Jesus, only Savior, sanctify forever. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life.
This morning's reading is from Psalms 119, 97 through 106. Oh, how I love your law. It is my meditation all the day. Your commandments make me wiser than my enemies, for it is ever with me. I have more understanding than all my teachers, for your testimonies are my meditation. I understand more than the aged, for I keep your precepts. I hold back my feet from every evil way in order to keep your word. I do not turn aside from your rules, for they have taught me. How sweet are your words to my taste, sweeter than honey to my mouth. Although your precepts I get understanding, therefore I hate every false way. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. I have sworn an oath and confirmed it to keep the righteous ways, rules.
Good. Thank you, Scott. Good morning. Okay, so let's do that so that those that are joining us online can hear that you're here. Good morning. Oh, there we go. There we go. Good to see everyone. And again, welcome to our online church family as well. This has been a blessing that we've been able to connect this way. Yet, as we've said a few times already this morning, we hunger to get back together and to be together. I have one more button to press before I get ready, and then, okay, there. Let's go to work, shall we? Spiritual disciplines, spiritual formation, the idea of getting stronger, growing stronger in our connection to God, the idea of getting stronger, growing stronger in our faith. Why? Why? On the back of our bulletin, in the little section labeled where to find it, usually we try to have the scripture reading text there and have that available. It was there, a part of our scripture reading. You can have it handy to look at it later. But at the very bottom, I've added one short verse. And one short verse that connects us to the why, that begins to connect us to why would we want to grow in further knowledge and understanding of God? Why would we want to connect to Jesus better day by day, week by week? Why would we want to go to the effort of using something physical, some activity that we can do to grow the spiritual? It's what we have said as sort of a definition of spiritual disciplines. At the very bottom, Matthew, of the backside of our bulletin, Matthew chapter 13, 44 is there. And if we think of our connection to Jesus, Jesus came as king. Jesus came as prophet. Jesus came as priest to fulfill all of those elements of the old covenant, the old law, God relating to mankind, all in one. Jesus, King Jesus says, the kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hidden in a field. When a man found it, class, what did he do? He hid it again, and then in his joy he went and sold all that he had and bought the field. Jesus gives that as a metaphor, as a parable, as a connection for us. When we find our way to Jesus, when we find our understanding, when we find our connection to God, when we find our desire to really, really connect further with Him, Jesus said, it's like if you found a treasure and you gave up everything to go get that physical treasure. So I'm asking, challenging, inviting everyone to join in and give all to find this treasure. Okay, so just to recap and connect everyone on the same page, as we've been talking about spiritual growth and spiritual disciplines, we talked about a further illustration of the why is in John chapter 15, where Jesus says multiple times, abide in me, connect to me, stay with me, be with me, abide in me. Jesus uses the word. And for those who abide in him, they stay connected, they bear fruit, they grow, they become stronger followers of him. So abide in him. In fact, I'm just going to put in a commercial here and then move on. And our Wednesday night Bible study, we're stepping through the Gospel of John. So I want to invite everyone to tune in and to join in. And if you can, when you can, join us. But as in chapter 15 of John, where Jesus says, abide in me and I will abide in you, and you stay connected, and he uses the illustration of a vine and a branch, you stay connected and you can bear fruit. More to the why. From our reading this morning, oh, how I love your law. It's my meditation all the day. The psalmist, well, David says, I meditate on this all day. And then he steps through a few of his whys, a few of his comments that David says, this is what it means to me. I'm connected to God's precepts, laws, understanding. I put those in my heart. And for that reason, he says, I have more understanding than my teachers because I'm connected to God's law. I understand more than the aged because I keep your precepts. I hold my feet back from evil because I'm in your word. I do not turn aside from your rules because, oh God, you've taught me how sweet are your words to taste. Through your precepts, I get understanding. As the psalmist steps through his view of God's word. And then he says, your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. We get that connection, right? We get that metaphor. We get that where the psalmist says, I'm walking along in the dark. As we live this life, and maybe you've experienced this, maybe you've come to various stages of life and think, whoa, I really don't know what to do next. Wow, this is all new. Maybe at every turn you find yourself, this is all new. I think that's probably what many of us said through most of last year. This is new. This is different. And David says, your word, oh God, is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. I have sworn an oath to confirm it. David says, I'm going to stay connected to your word no matter what. So the question is, and we've camped on this, if you knew that you would live forever, what would you want to be like? Every year when people come to the new year and they say, I want to make changes, I want to make new resolutions. By the way, the 31st of January, how you doing on that? I know, actually, statistically says most of us, they're long gone. But as we keep working on this, here's one thing that we can do, not just this week, not just this year, but always, to connect to our God. If you knew you would live forever, and class, we know, right? Church, we're going to live forever. How do you want to be? Through this, we're going to connect to God, strengthen our connection, deepen our relationship. And through various kinds of spiritual disciplines that we can do to achieve that deeper connection. As we study these. Today, we're going to look at reading and scripture. And Paul writes to the Colossians, whatever you do in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus. These are the things that we want to do. Okay, so a picture and then we'll move on. So last week, we had Aaron came and helped us with a description of batting training for playing softball at that higher level. You know, he brought us into the city church league, and we had lots of fun for the last few years just having fun playing softball. And I could brag just a little bit. We got the prize at the end of the year for the best sportsman the first 2 years that we were a part of that. So that's kind of okay, just going to brag about our softball team. But as last week, as Aaron shared with us, you know, some of those details of what it really takes to improve his batting, or anyone batting to play softball, he brought his T-ball batting tees. And I don't know, when you saw those, I mentioned this last week, for me, I saw those when I was in the first grade or kindergarten, whenever it was, and we played T-ball. And then I figured, you never see those again. Well, we didn't the few times that I played. But I figured that was it. If you notice up in the corner of this picture, the drink totes there are emblazoned with the NCAA emblem. Aaron sent me this picture because he had taken it at the College World Series. And I said, if you have any, he said to me as we were planning for last week, he said, Greg, you see batting tees at every level. You go to a major league ballpark and they're off to the side. This is how the best of the best train. And I said, send me some pictures. So this is a College World Series. And the baseball players at that level practice their swings from a tee. Yeah, we made that connection last week, right? And I want to make that again. It's the fundamentals. As we talk about praying and connecting to God in prayer last, and today, reading, and in our scripture reading, as we walk through more of these to come, it's about the fundamentals. The athlete practices the fundamentals because in real life, things change up and somebody might throw you a curveball. Does that metaphor fit with our day-to-day life? We want to practice the fundamentals of staying connected to Jesus, abiding with Him, living with Him, connecting with Him. We want to practice and stick with the fundamentals of communing with our Heavenly Father. Because life from day to day changes. It can throw us a curveball, right? Because that's the way it works. So, of the spiritual disciplines and spiritual formation, we actually, I've mentioned that scholars often put a list of personal spiritual disciplines and a corporate or a church body spiritual disciplines. Reading is obviously one of those that would fall on both of those categories. Reading as individuals as well as reading as a body of believers. This is life in God's Word. People might ask you, when you meet someone new, what do you do, right? Where do you live? Those things tell us something about this new person that we're meeting. Those things that you tell others about you. We live in Nebraska. It's different than other parts of the country. Life in Nebraska is different than other parts of the country. Life on a job site, building a house is different than life, than working in an office sitting in a cubicle, right? We get that. It says something about where you work and what you do. Life in God's Word is meant to be different than day-to-day life in this world that we live. Day-to-day life in this world is immersed in the problems and difficulties. But life in God's Word, He has, as the psalmist said, "Your precepts guide me in my ways, or like a lamp to my feet." Listening in God's Word. Reading God's Word is a way of connecting to Him. Listening, hearing what He has to say, putting it in our heart, putting it in our mind, having it in our memory, ready to go. Growing in God's Word, not just reading 10 verses once a week because we read along with the scripture reading at church, but making those connections regularly. Okay, towards that end, I want to read several scriptures because we're talking about Bible reading. So we're going to start with several scriptures here, just one right after another, about personal reading. And then I'm going to ask Wes to come back up and read a passage from Philippians. And we're going to make a connection about Paul's writings in the New Testament for us. Okay, so let's go. 2 Timothy chapter 2:15. Paul writes to young Timothy, "Do your best to present yourselves to God as one approved." Connect to God. Present yourself to God. "As a worker who has no need to be ashamed, rightly handling the word of truth," connecting to God's Word. Again, later in that letter, Paul writes, "From your childhood you have been acquainted with the sacred writings." So we'll stop and we'll catch this context, right, so that we all are on the same page. If Paul's writing this in the first century, at the birth of the new church, at the birth of the Christian movement, right? So when he says to Timothy, "You've been familiar with the sacred scripture," that's what we call the Old Testament, right? "Anyway, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All scripture is God-breathed, is breathed out by God, and profitable for teaching and reproof and correction and for training in righteousness." Scripture does all of this for us. Catch that again. All scripture breathed out by God and is profitable for reproof and correction and our training in righteousness. From our reading, the Psalm chapter 119, or before our reading this morning, verse 11, "I have stored up your word in my heart, that I might not sin against you." The psalmist said, I put your word in my heart. This is how I use God's word every day. This is how we can use God's word every day to benefit our life, to benefit our connections to one another. We put God's word in our life. Hebrews chapter 4, the word of God is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing the division of soul and spirit. So not just a piece of metal, not just a metal sword, but the word of God is sharper than that, dividing the spirit and soul. Joints and marrow, discerning the thoughts and intention of the heart. God's word is meant to get inside us. God's word is meant to work inside of us. The first letter to Timothy, Paul writes, until I come, devote yourself to public reading of Scripture and to the exhortation and teaching. Paul was encouraging his students through Timothy and others to read publicly the Scripture. 1 Peter chapter 2. Like newborn infants, long for pure spiritual milk, that by it you may grow up in salvation. We know infants, right? We know babies. When they're ready to be fed, when they call for milk, when they call to be fed, man, it's urgent for them, right? It's what they want. A newborn infant, it's all they want. Peter writes to new Christians. Peter writes to us. Peter writes to you and me and says, desire the word of God like a newborn infant. So Paul writes many of the letters in the New Testament. Others have written other. Peter wrote some. There are other, the Hebrews we quoted. We don't know the exact author. But these different portions of the New Testament point us to connecting to God's word. Individually, we do that. But we can also do that publicly, as a church, as a family, as a body of believers. Wes, would you come on up, and I'll get out of the way, and you can read. It's Philippians 1, the first 11 verses.
Paul and Timothy, bondservants of Jesus Christ, to all the saints in Christ Jesus who are in Philippi, with the bishops and deacons, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I thank my God upon every remembrance of you, always in every prayer of mine, making a request for you all with joy, for your fellowship in the gospel from the first day until now, being confident of this very thing, that he who has begun a good work in you will complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. Just as it is right for me to think of this of you of all, because I have you in my heart, inasmuch as both in my chains and in my defense and confirmation of the gospel, you are all partakers with me of grace. For God is my witness how greatly I long for you with all the affection of Jesus Christ. And this I pray, that your love may abound still more and more in knowledge and all discernment, that you may approve the things that are excellent, that you may be sincere and without offense till the day of Christ, being filled with the fruits of righteousness which are by Jesus Christ, to the glory and praise of God.
Thanks, Wes. It just helps to break up, to have a different voice. But think about what he just read, and Paul's encouraging young Christians to grow and to develop. But we would notice that if we read the first chapter of Ephesians, and then Philippians, and then Colossians, and the rest of Paul's letters, in the first chapter, somewhere in there he would say, I thank my God for all of you. I thank my God for you, and every time I pray, in my remembrance of you, I thank my God for you. Paul's writing to these churches to encourage them. The word of God is meant to encourage us. And at the end of chapter 6 of Ephesians, Paul's writing, and he says, in fact, I've sent Tychicus was his name, with this letter, ask him whatever you want. But Paul sent a commentary along with the letter that he sent, you could say, his friend Tychicus. And then he said, at the end of Colossians, he wrote, by the way, read the letter that I wrote to the Laodiceans and share this letter with them. The idea was these letters, this scripture that we have in the New Testament was meant to be passed on. Now, as we said last week about prayer, a sentence prayer, a word prayer said in a moment of difficulty, in a time of thanksgiving, in a time of joy, or in a time of sadness. Imagine having these words on your heart. As we said, imagine yourself in that difficult work situation and having a breath prayer ready to pray for that other coworker that might be difficult. Well, now imagine having the words on your mouth from Scripture, having Paul's words, I thank my God every time I think of you. Okay, he's writing to the churches, and I'm going to take a little liberty in applying this. Okay, I'll admit that up front. Just imagine you have that coworker, right? That coworker. And when the difficult times come, your mind goes to, I thank my God every time I think of you. Oh, that's not the human way of thinking, is it? That's not the way our minds normally work. But what if you put Scripture on your heart and in your mind in a way that you have good thoughts ready? Paul says, in whatever you do, think about the good things that are pure and right and holy. Think on these things. C.S. Lewis, you probably recognize that name, an author of many works describing the Christian walk to the world. He set out as his task to write about God, to write about Jesus, to write about the Christian life so that others could understand it. This is C.S. Lewis. Those who would like the God of Scripture to be more purely ethical in the writings do not know what they ask. We want to change God's words, in other words, and we don't know what we ask. New sentence, C.S. Lewis. We come to Scripture not to learn a subject, but to steep ourselves in a person. We come not to learn new words, not to understand this thing or that thing, but to steep ourselves in our connection with Jesus Christ and our Father in heaven. This week, our challenge is to take time, to set time, to make a reading plan. I would invite everyone to do that. If during the last year, as we were reading some things together, if you created a reading time, I hope you stick with that time or that plan. If you haven't done that in a while, I want to invite everyone. Maybe it's early in the morning, maybe it's at bedtime. Find a time to connect yourself in Scripture, to Scripture, through Scripture. The psalmist says, your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. This week, let's make this week a life in God's word. We have a song that has been selected, Just As I Am. We normally sing two short verses. We're going to sing three short verses today. And think about the words as we sing these, as we close together. Let's stand together as we sing.
Just as I am, without one plea, but that thy blood was shed for me, and that thou bidst me come to thee, O Lamb of God, I come, I come. Just as I am, though tall, just as I am thy love unknown, as broken every barrier down, now to be thine, yea, thine alone, O Lamb of God, I come. I come.
Would you pray with me, please, as we close? Heavenly Father, we're so very thankful and blessed that we could be here together this morning and to offer our worship and praise to you and to encourage one another. We hope that we have been a blessing to you and a blessing to those that are able to watch us online, and especially to those that gathered here this morning. We're very mindful of some of our members and family and friends that are dealing with illnesses and cancer and so many things going on in the world right now. Please give them comfort and peace as only you can, and help us each and every one to encourage them and to offer our help in whatever way that we can. Bless us as we go from here. Keep us close to you. Forgive us when we fall short, and watch over those of our number who are hurting. In Jesus' name, amen.
Church Online. Hey. Oh, okay. Hang on, let me make sure that I've got some sound going here. Trying to do this as fast as I can, and I'm messing up. Nope. Well, okay, we'll let it go that way. Yeah, I'm watching what's going out.